And power crews all across the state are busy right now trying to restore power knocked out by these strong storms. The latest numbers in from PSNH, there's a little over 25,000 customers who have no power right now. At the New Hampshire Electric Co-op, there are about 21,000 customers in the dark.
And several roads in Cheshire County are blocked by trees. Another area that we are hearing has been hard hit by the storms is Plymouth. This is a picture of one of the roads blocked by a downed tree. And there is a tree down at the corner of Pleasant and Broadway streets. And this is the scene on Thurlow Street. Our Adam Sexton has just arrived in Plymouth and joins us live now on the phone. Adam?
Yeah, well, Tom and Jen, it's very moderate tree damage from what we can see along those streets as you described them. Emergency dispatchers are very busy. They tell us they've got several reports of trees down. Again, those locations, Thurlow Street, Pleasant and Broadway, High Street, and the Barley House on the Plymouth State campus. We're told that a tree limb came down and slightly damaged that house. Campus police have also told us that the entire school actually lost power for about 5 minutes, and they had alarms going off in buildings and some minor water leaks, but overall not bad as far as the damage there. 21,000 total power outages from Meredith to Plymouth. It's looking right now like a lot of people are out of power, just standing around outside their homes. In fact, at this point, the arrival of our satellite truck seems to be the biggest attraction right now. But also, we had a water rescue this afternoon along the Pemigewasset River. Surrounding towns did respond to help, but limited information about that right now. We will try and update that information for you, and hopefully we can get you a live look at some of these trees down later in the newscast. Tom and Jen.
Okay, Adam, thanks. Firefighters have also been busy battling fires in just the last couple of hours. In Chester, an abandoned building was hit by lightning. One section of 121 is closed while firefighters are cleaning up the scene. There have also been at least two reported fires in Alton since the storms rolled through. And a viewer in Rochester sent in this picture that you see, lightning taking down that huge pine tree. From the looks of it, it fell right on top of the patio furniture just below.